it is, Levi. Levi, baby.
Chief Priest.
Be done in decency and order. Let the brother give his speech. Let's rock it out.
Come
on. All right. Of course. All right, of course, first and foremost, I give all praise, honor, and glory to the Most High God, Yahweh. We do so in the name of the only begotten Son, Mashiach Yahweh Shah. All right. Brother Gorilla Hebrew, for those of you that don't know me, or Chief Priest Allah's over here, whatever you want to call me, it's all too good. Anyway, supposed to be the Hebrews on trial event. So I'm going to get right into it, all right? Here. All right. The Hebrew culture has been accused of plagiarism by various proponents and fanboys of the culture of ancient Kemet. In particular, claims are made that the Hebrew Torah sees its origin in Kemet's Mayat. Much like many of the other empty claims and mud slung at the Hebrew culture, this is entirely unfounded. To prove that, let's do what the accusers have yet to ever do and actually compare Torah and Mayat. Right. All right? Your worst nightmare just became true. All the bullshit y'all been talking is about to be found out to be a straight lie.
Right.
Mayat and Torah parallels. So we're going to go through any parallel we can find in Mayat to Torah. As we can see here, it says, I have not committed robbery with violence. I have not stolen, I have not stolen food, I am not deceitful, I have not told lies. Alright, basically they tell you not to steal a whole bunch of time, alright? These five principles of Mayat correspond to only two verses in the Bible. Let's read them. Exodus 20 and 15.
Get it.
You're great.
Talk to
him. Exodus 20 and 15 here in the Ten
Commandments. Bring
it up. Go ahead.
Book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 15. Thou shalt not steal.
Plain and simple. Thou shalt not steal. Now get Leviticus 19:11, right? Thou shalt not steal. So all these five correspond here and here, right? Leviticus 19:11.
Book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 11. Ye shall not steal, neither deal falsely, neither lie one to another.
So in one verse we find out not to lie or steal. Y'all got five times telling you not to steal and not to lie. See, here's the issue, right? People in the Kemetic community have no idea what the hell they be talking about when they try to accuse the Bible. Let me explain.
Bring it out.
Jabari had a sit down with the brother Zion Lex. In that, he said eight of the Ten Commandments are seen in Mayat. Never at any point did he go into Mayat to substantiate that. What he doesn't realize is it's not eight of the Ten Commandments, but it's eight of the 613 commandments.
That's right.
That you can draw parallels to.
If we
plagiarize eight of ten, that would make sense for you to call us liars and stealers and plagiarists. But eight of 613, that's ludicrous, and we'll come back to that.
Break it down, huh?
So now let's look at another one. I have not slain man or woman. Exodus 20 and 13. Yes, sir. Stay there. We going there.
Let's get it, baby. Let's get it.
Go. Book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 13. Thou shalt not kill.
14.
Period. Thou shalt not kill. That's it. 20 and 13. Thou shalt not kill. Now it tells us two times in my act, I have not committed adultery, and I have not seduced anyone's wife. Exodus 20 and 14.
Exodus 20 and 14. Thou shalt not commit adultery.
Boom, right there. Then we got, I have not stolen anyone's land. Deuteronomy 27 and 17.
Deuteronomy chapter 27, verse 17. Cursed be he that removeth his neighbor's landmark, and all the people shall say amen.
There we go. So of the 8 verses that we can find in my eye that correspond with Torah, they only actually relate to 5 laws in the Bible. So the only thing y'all can say is we borrowed 5 laws. But here's the thing, with this in mind, it is highly problematic to assert 9 parallels per 613. If we're going to borrow, why don't we borrow 9? Why don't we borrow all 42 of the negative possessions?
Talk to him.
That's right.
Let's deal with what the word, the etymological definition of problematic. Comes from the circa 1600, doubtful and questionable. Reasonably, we should doubt and question that the Hebrew Torah borrows anything from Mayah, all right? Why? Because of the lack of Mayahic principles that we see reflected in the Torah. Let's move on. Any sensible group of people wouldn't steal from, kill, or commit adultery against each other. This is not anything that Kemet had a monopoly on. This is right. Common sense. Don't rob and kill where you live at.
Right?
No one has a monopoly on these things. With that being said, the notion that Torah borrowed from or plagiarized by Yah is out the window. That's gone. Never say that again. You've been disqualified from the
Talk to him, man.
Right.
Bring it out.
Talk to him.
With that being said, let's put Mayat further under the microscope. Mayat is supposed to mean balance. The problem is Mayat isn't balanced.
All right.
Proverbs 11 and 1. Let's prove Mayat isn't balanced.
Don't do it, bro.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Proverbs 11, verse 1. A false balance is abomination to the Most High.
Balance is something that's important. We all can bear witness to that. The Most High says in the Bible it's abomination to him, meaning God hates it. So let's prove that Mayat is an abomination. Commissions constantly throw the word reciprocity out, though there is not one example of reciprocity in Kemet whatsoever. It tells me what not to do, or what I haven't done rather than negative confessions, but not what the punishment is for doing it.
Right.
When will I be punished? In some spooky afterlife? Maybe that's why so many hoteps blaspheme Mayat daily, though claiming to uphold it. If Mayat is absent reciprocity, anyone that claims that it includes reciprocity is in fact violating Mayat by telling a liar being deceitful, which when we go back here it says, of course, I have not lied.
Right. Right.
So if you say that Mayat is balanced and has reciprocity, you blaspheme the Mayat.
Right.
That's right.
You're a liar. Is there reciprocity in Mayat or Torah? Mayat tells us I have not stolen. Give me numbers 5 and 6. And read to the 7th verse. Mayat tells me I have not stolen. That's the confession. That's cool. Let's see what the Torah tells me. Go ahead.
Book of Numbers, chapter 5, verse 6.
Uh-huh.
Speak unto the children of Israel,
uh-huh,
when a man or woman shall commit any sin that men commit,
uh-huh,
to do a trespass against the Lord, and that person be guilty.
If you're guilty of stealing, read on.
Then they shall confess their sins which they have done,
uh-huh,
and he shall recompense his trespass.
He shall recompense, meaning if I steal from you, I have to pay it back. That's what the Torah says. Read on.
With the principle thereof.
With the amount of, with the what's the word I'm looking for? With the fiscal amount of whatever I stole from you, the monetary value, plus what?
It says, and add unto it the 5th part thereof.
So if I steal $100 from you, I have to pay you back $120. That's what the Bible says. My eye just tells me I didn't steal. So where is the reciprocity? It is non-existent. Again, when you assert that there is reciprocity in my eye, you lie and you blaspheme my eye.
Talk to him, baby. Talk to him.
Let's go to Leviticus 20 and 10. It says in my eye, I have not committed adultery. This is what it says in my eye, I have not committed adultery. Let's go to Leviticus 20 and 10. Go ahead.
Book of Leviticus, chapter 20, verse 10.
Uh-huh.
And the man that committed adultery with another man's wife, even he that committed adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death.
Be put to death. See, if I sleep with your wife, I gotta die.
That's right.
I just haven't slept with anyone's wife. That's cool, my dude. But if I did, what you gonna do about it?
Right.
That doesn't teach anybody not to do anything. All right.
Give me
Deuteronomy 4.
You know how it is.
Deuteronomy 4. With all this in mind, this is why this is written in Torah. Go ahead.
Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 4, verse 5. Behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments, even as the Lord my God commanded me, that ye should do so in the land whither ye go to possess it.
So this is the Most High speaking to Moses. I have taught you statutes and judgments. Read on.
Verse 6. Keep therefore and do them, for this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations.
In the sight of the nations, because the nations didn't have the sense to have this type of law that we had. Egypt included.
Go ahead. Which shall hear all these statutes and say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people.
See, we wise and understanding. Why? Because we have a check and balance system that is not seen anywhere else.
That's right.
We have a check and balance system that strictness is not seen or paralleled in other contemporary societies. It is clear from the most rudimentary observations that not only is Kemetic culture and its morality both inadequate and incomplete, but overall impractical and should be emphatically taken off the table with prejudice as a means of revolution, upliftment, or any of the like thereof for blacks in the hells of North Central and South America.
That's right.
Bring it out. Listen, how can we honestly boast of the exploits of a place and deem it the originator of civilization when it can't be proven to be an actual civilization? I repeat, you cannot prove ancient Kemet was a civilization.
That's
a bold statement, ain't it?
You said what?
You cannot prove ancient Kemet was a civilization. Egyptian civilization, question mark, right? Where do I get the bold claim from? It's the etymological definition of the word itself. Civilization, circa 1704, law which makes a criminal process civil. That is the true or the etymological definition of the word civilization. Again, the law which makes a criminal process civil. All right. We have no actual records of such a system in Kemet. My app features 42 negative confessions, no aspect of which defining criminality and or a process where civil action can be taken against the violator. The Bible, you know. The Medo-Netra ain't even got a word for the word judge. So instead of papyrus, pyramid, wall, or whatever is produced out of the judicial process in Egypt, it cannot be called a civilization.
Right.
All right? So in closing, because I know I ain't got much time, we're going to do a quick recap. Torah did not come from Mayat. That's been emphatically proved.
Right.
Mayat is a false balance. That's been emphatically proved.
Right.
Kemet has yet to be proven to be a civilization, therefore cannot be claimed to be more the originator of it.
That's right.
Listen, man. In my eye, if you sin, there's no judgment. If you commit adultery, there's no judgment. But according to the Bible, if you commit any of these